In today's video, I'm going to show you how to start learning cybersecurity and ethical hacking from your Android device. We just need a web browser, but at the end of the video, I will show you the best one. We are going to use some web platforms that provide us with virtual machines like the one you are seeing right now. So let's start. The first platform we are going to see is basically HackTheBox Academy. This platform is from HackTheBox, probably you already know it. It's a very famous cybersecurity platform. But this is the Academy, where you can find the basics to learn everything that you are going to need later in the HackTheBox platform that I will show you. And here in the left part, we have basically all the menu. We can click on modules just to look at all the different options. And we are going to see, for example, the modules that I already own. There are a lot of free ones, so I recommend taking a look at them. Basically, the fundamentals and the easy, most of them are free, or you can get them for free. And I recommend you taking a look to all of them, because there are fundamentals courses for all of the most famous operating systems, for Linux, Windows, and macOS. There are introduction to networking, for example. There are introduction to web exploiting and web cybersecurity. So basically, you can find a lot of good information here, very structured, like you see right now. You can click on one course. You have all the information here. You have to read it and study it a little bit. And then you can do an ascensor question. For example, in the right part, we can start a machine. This will open basically a virtual machine where there are some programs or there are some files already configured for us related to the course, or to the module that we are studying right now. You can see that you have basically a Linux terminal. You can use this, and this is not using your Android CPU or your Android GPU. This is online. This is for free. I think it has some limited time. I'm not sure if you have like 1 hour of use or something like that, and you need to power off and restart the machine or something like that. But you can see that you can use this like a Linux machine to start learning. So as I said, just select some modules and you can start learning. For example, apart from the modules, you can select the paths. And here you can find several paths. A path is a group of different modules with the same topic or the same thematic. For example, here you can see operating system fundamentals. You can click on the modules that are inside the path, and you can start doing them one by one. In this case, for example, you can do the modules in the order you want, but there are other paths that you have to do the first module, then the second, then the third, and so on. I think this is one of the best ways to start learning the basics, because you have already here all the information and this is free. So you just need to start reading everything, study it, maybe taking some notes and studying again later. But with this, you will understand the basics that you are going to need in cybersecurity. So now we can take a look, for example, to the paid part, because here by default you have some tokens that are like some green cubes, and you can buy more. With this token, you can buy new modules. Usually the harder the module or the more technical, the more tokens or more cubes it costs. And also, apart from all the modules and the paths, you can see here that you have different badges. These are like some recognitions that they give to you when you complete a module or you complete a path or something like that, so you keep motivated. And also, you have here the exams. These are paid exams, but you can add them to your curriculum vitae if you complete them, because they usually have quite a lot of recognition. So now, apart from this web platform, I recommend you also TryHackMe, which is a bit similar to HackTheBox, but with different paths and with different learning modules. So here, for example, we can go to the learn path. We have different options. Let's click on learn, and we can see the different learning paths that we have in this application, in TryHackMe. Here you have introduction to cybersecurity, junior pen testing, also something more oriented to SOC, web fundamentals, whatever. So let's click, for example, in the first one, introduction to cybersecurity, and you will have inside this different modules. For example, introduction to cybersecurity, and we have inside of it another three modules. Each module has like different tasks that you need to complete one after another, So you will be learning the basics or whatever the module offers to you. Also, you can start some machines like we saw in HackTheBox. Here at the right part, we have spawned a virtual machine with Parrot OS, if I'm not mistaken. And at the left part, you can continue reading all the module. And for example, here we are going to copy and execute the command we need to do. So let's open a terminal. We can paste the command we need to execute. This is to search a directory in a web server, for example. And basically you just need to do whatever they are explaining to you. Here we are going to look for a new URL inside a web server. And when we go to that URL, we need to do some operation and we are going to find this flag. This is very similar to a CTF or capture the flag event. So you just need to complete all the different tasks or answer if you need to write some answer in the task and just click on the complete button. That's how you complete a module, so you can go to the next one. You also have, apart from the learning paths, you have the practice part. These are basically challenges or CTFs that they are doing, so you can join one. If you don't know what is a CTF, it's basically a cybersecurity competition where you can resolve different kind of challenges and learn a lot, so I recommend you to participate on them. And here we can see, as a curiosity, the different paid versions they have. In general, I find that TryHackMe is quite cheaper than HackTheBox Academy, but you can use both. And now, from HackTheBox, apart from the Academy, we have the main platform, which is HackTheBox. Here you will find a lot of different virtual machines that you are going to hack, and if you hack a machine, you will earn some points. Here, for example, they have a learning an entry point, so first of all, take a look at it, and they will explain how it works and what you need. And here you have all the different machines that you can hack. You can connect with a VPN to a network, and from that network you can run basically any tool you want against that machine. Apart from that, you have also challenges, like before, these are CTF challenges, so you can come here, they are mostly offline, they have different categories, you can download it and try to solve them. And they have also added this recently, I think, the Sherlock's, which is basically all oriented to defense, not just attack. And now I'm going to do some testing because I found that if you use, for example, the Chrome web browser in your Android device, it might not work properly. I'm going to spawn the virtual machine we saw previously. We are going to go to the module I show, start machine. The machine is going to open fine at the right part, but if I try to write with my wireless Bluetooth keyboard connected to the tablet, I'm not going to be able to write anything. So instead of using Chrome, I recommend you using Kiwi browser. I will leave the link below in the video description. So here you can see that I can write without any problem. I hope you like this video, although it's a bit different. And don't forget to subscribe, share, and like.